yards out. Hargreaves tidies up for Torquay. Plays the ball back to Nicholson. He launches the ball forward. It's forward towards Roscoe Desailly, who tries to lob Ward. And it's a great save by Gavin Ward.
Ian Beddow is watching a little bit of Premier League history for us.
Yeah, Stoke fans have waited 23 years to see a home game in the top tier, and they're ecstatic after the first 45 minutes.
We've got a game on here. It's Port Vale 1, Scunthorpe 1. Scunthorpe opened the scoring on 11 minutes.
Torrential rain almost prevented this game from going ahead at Newcastle's Lime Valley Stadium. Even referee Mr. Langford had time to joke with the players during the warm-up on his thoughts on the pitch.
Great game, two sides prepared to play, real entertainment at the Liberty. What a scalp for the Swans. It finished Swansea 3, Wolves 1.
Well, let's get some reaction from the racecourse now. Ian Beddow has been speaking to the club secretary, Geraint Parry.
Any reasoning behind why Brian's gone? Have you heard anything?
No, they've been chatting over the last few days. I've spoken to the manager a few times, we'll see.
Well, Ian Beddow can tell you more.
There is the final whistle, and you can hear the celebrations. The crowd went onto the pitch. It is Mackin. Oh, and that's a wonderful strike from Levi Mackin. It's finished. Stoke City 3, Aston Villa 2. The final goal, the winning goal, coming in the very final minute of stoppage time from Mamadi Sidibe.
And if Van Persie thinks he's in for an easy ride against his old friend tomorrow, Lubins has a message about his approach to the meeting.
No fear, no fear at all. I know all his tricks, so let's bring it on.